these 5 ChatGPT life hacks will help you stay a lot more productive and also will ease up your life a lot. Ever since I've started using ChatGPT in this way, I have been able to work a lot more efficiently. In case you are new over here, hey guys, my name is Prithvi Raj. I'm an electronic music producer, a part-time gamer, and also I try to make videos. Firstly, I want to show you how you can improve your communications by miles. It has helped me write emails, but it has also helped me write WhatsApp messages. For example, if you match with the girl of your dreams on Tinder and you are looking for the perfect icebreaker, then just ask away. And now she's your girlfriend and you messed things up and you wanted to send her an apology text. Just ask ChatGPT, help me write an apology text to my girlfriend in one sentence. And you know the drill and how it goes. You might already know that it can help you draft emails quite nicely, but you can also use it to respond to certain emails that will help you get out of a sticky situation. For example, if your boss sent you a mail questioning your work ethic, firstly, I want to say that, don't worry, King, you're doing your best. Now, how do you respond to such a mail? Just type in what happened and it will send you a draft email for that. It can generate human-like response quite nicely, so make sure you take the most advantage out of this feature. The next life hack is to use it as a search engine. I have literally started using it as my search engine for every small and silly questions I have. But the limitation that I was facing is that ChatGPT does not have access to latest and recent data. It only has information up to the year 2021. So for this case, we're gonna use Google Bard. It is the AI chatbot by Google. I recently made a video comparing ChatGPT with Google Bard. So if that's something you're interested in, then you can find the link of that video in the description or you can click the I button just right now. Instead of searching my general questions on Google, I just search it on Bard. For example, I recently purchased this Nikon Z30 and I already owned a Nikon 50mm f-mount lens. So I was wondering if I could use it with my Z30. So I asked this to Google Bard and it told me that I can use my existing Nikon lenses with the new Z30. But the thing is that I needed an adapter to use it with my existing lenses. I'll be honest, it did help me make my purchase decision and I went forward and bought the camera. Ever since that day, I've been using this as my default search engine across all my devices. You can just ask away your basic questions and it will give you the answer. And I was wondering if I could drink Diet Coke during a ketogenic diet. The good news was that I can actually have Diet Coke during a keto diet. It actually saved me a lot of time because if I had searched this on Google, then I most likely would have to find my answer from thousands of articles and that could be a drag to be honest. But in case you wanted more info about a certain topic, then you can always hit that Google it button at the end and it will take you to the results directly. Since Google Bard has all the latest info, you can ask for stock prices and even ask any current affairs questions if you had one. TLDR, it's basically a lifesaver for me. And if you're enjoying this video so far, then please consider hitting the subscribe button and you'll be able to be a lifesaver for me as well. TLDR stands for too long didn't read. Whenever I come across any long article, I just ask ChatGPT to summarize it for me. I love reading self-help books, but here's a reality check for you. 90% of the content in self-help books are mostly just fillers. They generally just circle around one single topic over and over again, except a few of course. But if you're not really into reading, then just ask ChatGPT to summarize a certain book for you and you can just read the book summary instead. For example, let us ask ChatGPT to summarize this book, The Psychology of Money by Morgan Housel. I will highly recommend that you read this book. I personally learned a major lesson from this book, so I'll leave a link of this book in the description just in case you're interested in that. Else you can just read the summary on ChatGPT. It can surely act as a major time saver for you. You can even summarize any contracts or any terms and conditions agreement you need to go through. This thing has surely helped me do my research related tasks where I have to go through several articles and note down points. You can really make the most out of this if you're a student. Speaking about students, it can basically be a game changer for you. I really wish something like ChatGPT existed when I was a student myself. You can literally ask your math problems. Algebra and calculus weren't really my thing, so yeah, it can really help you with your homework. You can just ask ChatGPT to explain the laws of thermodynamics and it will do it for you in a very simple way. You can even ask ChatGPT to teach you how to play the guitar or the piano and it will guide you with the steps. It can also teach you softwares like Photoshop or how you can use a DSLR camera, for example. Another thing you can learn from ChatGPT is a different language. I recently started learning Spanish and it surely has been a lot help. Hola, ¿cómo estás? Hola, ¿cómo estás? And lastly, this is the most helpful hack for me. I'm able to generate new content ideas using ChatGPT. This is gonna be really helpful if you're a content creator. If you are a YouTuber, it can help you brainstorm video ideas. For example, if you create video editing tutorials, you can simply search video editing tutorial ideas for YouTube and it will give you a list of ideas you can choose from. If you write blogs, it can also help you with that. It will give you ideas. And on top of that, you can even make it write the blog for you and you can just make some changes if you want. ChatGPT can also help you get that perfect caption for your Instagram posts. The way I use it the most is for writing song lyrics. I can simply explain the type of the song I want to create and it will do the job for me. I can even ask it to write me a song like a specific artist. For example, write me a lyrics like Avicii with the chords, of course. It is really useful and it can help you get the inspiration you might need to get started. Would you like to share some tips with me as well? Then please feel free to leave a comment down below. Click here to check out a list of apps that might help you stay productive. Please consider liking this video and also subscribing to my channel for more such videos like this. And I'll catch you guys in the next video real soon. Till then, have a great day ahead. And I want you to be